Today I will show you how you can easily build your own Z80 base home computer. The computer is based on a Zilog Z80 CPU which runs at 6 MHz, has 128 KB of RAM and 32 KB of EEPROM. And with an optional graphic card you can use monitor and keyboard to play with it. The card is based on the TMS9918 and it gives you a resolution of 256 by 192 pixels at 15 colors. It runs a CPM operating system and can store all these famous historic programs like WordStar, Microsoft Excel or games. And unlike many other DIY computers made today, this one works without any modern microcontrollers or CPLDs, but with components that were already available in the 80s and which are still easy to get. The only modern thing needed is an Arduino Mega and a Windows PC for setting it up. Maybe you have already watched the videos of my Z80 computer from scratch playlist. There you can see how everything works. Check it out. But now let's go ahead and build it up. Firstly, get the software and schematic from GitHub. You can find the link in the video description. Then tackle everything together. You can solder the parts on a breadboard like I did first. But this is no fun at all, it takes hours and will finally end up with thick layers of wire where it is hard to track down the mistakes you will definitely make. Luckily there is PCBGoGo. PCBGoGo offers services all around printed circuit boards. Bring your projects to the next level with a PCB from PCBGoGo. Go to the order page on the PCBGoGo website and enter a size of 100 by 100 mm. Select the desired number and optionally other parameters like the color of the solder mask and silkscreen. You get an offer immediately. 5 double-sided FR4 boards cost only $5 and you can even get them for free, so check it out. Now go ahead and upload the file gerber.zip from the repository. You can preview online how everything will turn out and within a few hours PCBGoGo will verify the files for you. If everything is okay, you can place the order. Then production will begin and you can track online how it proceeds. If the boards are ready, they will be shipped immediately. Depending on your carrier, you will get them a few days later. And if you don't want to wave the soldering iron yourself, you can let PCBGoGo solder them for you. So check out their assembly service. You will get a minimum of 5 boards. If you don't need them all, why don't you give 4 of them to your friends and tell them about this video? I will give mine to patrons and channel members who like to have one to replicate the project. So supporting this channel can pay off. Okay, let's assemble the board now. I always solder the parts in the order of their height. Best start with the resistors. They all have the same value of 10 kilo ohms. Here I overlooked that the connector actually needs more space than the footprint indicates. Thus the resistor must take place on the backside. In the version on GitHub, however, this error is corrected. After the resistors come the 4 blocking capacitors with 100 nanofarad each. Then come the ICs with DIP package. Personally I prefer to put them on sockets, but of course they can also be soldered directly. When soldering the oscillator module, take a close look on the silkscreen first. There you see 3 rounded edges and 1 sharp edge. The oscillator looks the same and so you know how to place it. I also put a DIP14 socket which I modified a bit to be able to change it easily when necessary. After the connectors and the rest of the components are assembled and the chips have been put in, you can start installing the software. As I said before, an Arduino Mega is used as programming device. The Arduino must be plugged into the rightmost pins of the bus connector where it is marked on the silkscreen. If you are using box connectors like I did, it will be necessary to cut an additional notch. So the Arduino will sit exactly where it is supposed to sit and there is no way to plug it in the wrong way. Also plug 2 jumper wires from RX and TX0 of the Arduino to TXB and RXB of the board. This connection is necessary to transfer files to the computer later. Also, hook up the terminal connection. I designed the board so that these USB serial converters can be inserted directly. So we can start a terminal emulation like PuTTY with a baud rate of 187.5 kilobaud and the default port setting with 8 data bits, 1 stop bit and no parity of flow control. Now compile and upload the loader sketch to the Arduino. You can do that with the Arduino IDE. Secondly, start the CPM loader app, choose the serial port to which the Arduino is connected and click on ROM image. When doing this for the first time, a file dialog pops up where you select the file rom.emg, then the upload to the EEPROM starts. After the upload is finished, the Z80 loads the kernel from EEPROM into RAM and then starts the CCP from the serial disk drive. A CPM prompt shows up. Now you can try the programs. Instead of directories, CPM uses 15 user numbers to structure files on disks. CPM always starts with user number 0, which contains all the tools that come with a CPM distribution. Enter type intro.txt to get a list of the programs and their user number. To start a program, just enter the drive letter followed by the user number and colon, then type the program name. Have fun! To install more programs, copy the files to one of the 15 user directories on your PC. Then click on Reload on the Loader app and your program is ready to use. To access it, enter a file followed by a colon, and here it is. To run your computer independently of Arduino and PC, you can plug in a PATA drive or compact flash card with adapter. Before, set jumper number 1 so that it gets its supply voltage through pin 20. Leave the other two at their defaults. Now power your computer up and click Reset in the Loader tool. Again, it boots from the serial drive. This time it states that a hard drive was found. Start the Make Disk utility to format it. Note that all data on the card will be lost forever. The utility creates 4 logical drives with 16 MB each. This should be enough for all CPM programs in the world. Copy all the files you need with the pip command. Change to drive C. With the dir command, you can check whether all the files have been successfully copied. When everything turned out well, you can remove the Arduino and after connecting power, it boots straight from drive C. You can easily extend your computer through extension modules. The modules can be connected with 64-pin IDC connectors which are lined up on a ribbon cable. You can of course also make a PCB for that. Up to 6 modules can be wired by this way. Here I made a graphic card based on the TMS9918, which was very popular back then. So we end up with a stack of PCBs from PCBGoGo. There is one more IDC connector left for the next module I will make. Connect it to the composite input of your TV or monitor now. Also plug in a PS2 or PS2 compatible USB keyboard and your computer is ready to go. You can start Microsoft Basic and write your own programs now, like in the 80s. If you have a PS2 keyboard, here is how it needs to be wired to the PCB. For USB keyboards, you can simply make an adapter cable from an old USB-A extension cord. However, this might not work with newer keyboards, because not all of these still support the PS2 protocol. Now it's up to you to put it into a neat enclosure. Maybe I will do that one day, but personally I'm more interested in designing circuits and programming software. And if you want to write software too, you can do that very conveniently. Perhaps you noticed the File button on the Loader tool earlier. When you click on it, a dialog pops up where you can choose the CPM executable. Then it creates a disk drive in the upper 16 kilobytes of EEPROM and puts the file there. And after a reset or power on, the computer automatically runs that program. So you can use it even without any compact flash card. This is particularly useful if you are writing programs for this machine. The loader detects whenever there is a new version. Then it upgrades this autostart file on the EEPROM and restarts it. Okay, if you made a cool program or an awesome project with this computer, let me know in the comments. Maybe I can mention it in one of my future videos. That's it for now. Find more details in the playlists I linked here and also on the GitHub page. Have fun and see you next time.